Well, static test A-OK. We've exceeded all known benchmarks for rocket power. She's ready for launch. Sir Hubert, Chief Bunch, shall we take a look?
I think it would be wise to widen the blast area just a bit.
No! It's my ship! I designed it, I built it, and I'm going to fly it!
I'm sorry, Professor, but the World Council has made its decision. This ship will be leading humanity's progress into space. The universe, far beyond the stars. We need the best pilot there is. A pilot of the future.
And just whom do you have in mind?
As far as I'm concerned, there's only one choice.
Dan Dare.
Dover Tower, you're cleared for supersonic flyby at 1,000 meters.
This is Captain Dan Dare calling Digby. How's it looking from down there, Dig?
Like a skyrocket crossed with an egg beater, if you don't mind my saying so, sir.
You may be right, Dig, but a supersonic helicopter would be a boon to worldwide medical transport. Let's give it a real push. Fire Rocket 2!
Rocket Copter, your angle of approach is too severe. Level out now.
That's the new Rocket Copter! This will be the first test to shatter the sound barrier.
Extruded titanium rotors?
That's right.
Were they tempered in liquid nitrogen?
I don't believe so.
They won't hold.
Approaching Mach 1 now. Time to go full buster. Firing Rocket 3.
Roger that, Rocket Doctor. We copy. Looking good, Rocket Doctor. Maintain your current heading.
Stand by for a galactic newsflash.
Skyward listeners, Dan the Man there is smoking the Stratus today!
Yeah! He's done it! He shattered the sound barrier!
All right, so you've made your mark on history. How's she handling?
Not the best, Dig. Losing stabilizer control. In fact, I think she's about to... I've lost the rotors. Cutting rocket power.
Bail out, sir. It's your only chance. Get out now.
No can do, Dig. This crate's overpopulated territory. Can't risk innocent lives. I'm flying it down.
But you've got no lift, sir. No rotors. And you're losing pinch fast.
Will he live through it?
He will, if anyone can.
Oh, take cover, listeners. We got a wingless bird coming in fast.
Dover Air Base, prepare for an emergency landing.
Comfort.
Emergency crew standing by. You are clear for landing on runway 2R.
Oops. This is Retro Rocket signing off and diving for cover!
Stand by, Dover. I'm coming in.
On the threshold.
Firing all rockets!
Phew. Captain's going to need a good cover after that one.
This. And you want him flying my ship? This lunatic? This hotshot? This... Oh, my goodness.
No, no, please continue. Maniac, perhaps? Candidate for the funny farm? How about just Dan? Professor Peabody, isn't it? I'm a great admirer of your work.
Excellent, Captain Dare. Because the World Council would like you to test-fly the Professor's latest creation.
But we must warn you, this could be the most dangerous mission of your career.
Well, despite a few moths in the tail, my luck seems to be holding up. Where are we going?
We're sending you to Venus.
Venus, eh? The evening star, the goddess of love.
Ooh, love can be treacherous, sir. And I've a feeling that planet will be the same.
No excitement without risk, Dig. Or as I like to think of it, no adventure without dare.
Excuse me?
The name's Hank. Hank Hogan.
Ah, yes. The American xenobiologist.
That's me, darling. Ace pilot, too, as you can see. Say, you wouldn't know where I could find some old geezer named Professor Peabody, do you? Figure I'm gonna have to babysit the old coot for most of this mission, so I might as well go make an impression.
Oh, what a good idea. But if you're looking for that old coot, Professor Peabody, I'm afraid you're talking to her. And I really wouldn't worry about making that impression, darling.
Hoo-wee.
We had only planned on a 3-person crew.
Sorry, sir, but we need an ace number one, a co-pilot. Digby used to be in Special Forces, and he's been my wingman since day one.
Where the captain goes, I go, sir.
Very well. I'll have a suit made up for him.
Ah, there you are. Here are the specs on the magnetoatomic drive. Study them carefully. The last test pilot didn't.
The last? Pierre Lafayette. He pioneered a smaller test ship last month.
He overloaded the drive. The ship malfunctioned, went off course.
We have no idea what happened to him.
Oh, and I had some leave coming up soon.
I knew Pierre. Shame. He was a great pilot.
But you're a better one. We are counting on you, Captain. If this mission to Venus is successful, we'll be launching the Kingfisher for a full-scale exploration of the planet.
It'll be a success, sir. You can count on that.
Just memorize those specs.
I already have.
Chantilly lace and a pretty face and a ponytail hanging down, wiggling a walk and a giggling a talk.
Yes, looks like the rumors are true, Rocket fans. The World Council is about to launch an actual mission into space.
Oh, just imagine shooting through space from Venus to Mars.
Oh, hey, and it looks like, yes, yes it is! It's the dashing Captain Dare himself, leading the mission.
Retro, the man is an irritating security risk.
I rather like him.
So, what are we calling this bird, anyhow?
Good question. Professor, any ideas?
Well, she's not very big, but she's tough and dependable.
Oh, sounds rather like my Aunt Anastasia.
I like it!
Works for me.
Then good luck to Captain Dare and the crew of the Anastasia.
And success on your flight to Venus.
Skyward, Dig! Let's make history!
Fueling of main engines completing. Loading gantry is clear of the ship.
Activating magnetic restraint systems.
Flight controllers, give me a go, no-go for launch.
Roger, Delta Tower.
Booster,
go.
Guidance,
go.
Control,
go.
Procedures,
go.
Capcom,
go.
Launch control, this is Dover
Tower.
We're in position. Go for launch.
Launch in 10, 9,
8, 7, 6, 5.
Vector angle 83.29. Activating the magnetoatomic drive.
1.
Sequence commencing. The clock is running.
Works like a charm.
All crews, nice work, people. Now, let's get cracking on that second ship.
Mr. Hogan.
Must you do that?
Dover, how are we looking?
You're looking good right down the middle.
We've done it! We're through the ionosphere! We're in space.
Next stop, Venus!
To be the first DJ in space. Wouldn't that be a blockbuster broadcast? Huh?
Well, well. What have we here?
Hey.
How's a bloke supposed to have a good cover without gravity?
Attention, crew. We're in final approach to Venus.
At last.
Roger, Anastasia, we copy.
In the clouds. They may be signs of life.
Or a storm.
The cloud formations are all wrong. It's life. I'm sure of it. Let's investigate.
Captain Dare at your service.
No.
Going in.
As an experienced biologist, I can tell you there's only one species I know of that makes flashes like that. And then only on special occasions.
Really? What kind of occasion?
Anyway,
we have to get out of here.
Bandits at 3 and 9 o'clock, firing main thrusters.
We're taking a hit.
Anastasia again, what is your status? Please respond.
Down 40% and falling. Rudder control's out. We can't land and we can't escape.
Only one chance. Dig, take the controls.
Wait! Where are you going?
Take the controls? What controls, sir? We're sitting ducks.
Steady on, Dig. I'm going to jettison the Explorer module. Separation in 6 seconds.
What? You can't! The Explorer isn't designed to fly!
But it's got steering thrusters. At 5,000 PSI each, you can use them for landing. Good luck, chaps. Disengaging Explorer locking bolts, now!
Captain Dare, you are go for separation.
So
Separation complete! I'm going down!
Dan!
Shut down.
Phew.
Tech 10 Altene. Sego Volstar. Ectino Lomaste comprende?
A rough neighborhood for a breakdown, and no mistake. Can't say I think much of the welcoming committee either. For a moment.
Astonishing. You mean this fruit allows you to understand another language?
Both parties must eat a comprende fruit from the same plant. We Theron developed it long ago.
Well, I'll be. Y'all make this little guy too?
Here, leave Stroppy alone.
We're humans from the planet Earth. We came in peace, but we seem to have wandered into a war. One of our party has been lost already.
Yes. The Treens, a warlike people from the north, were attempting to cross the volcanic belt and invade us. But I hear no more fighting. The Treens may have pulled back or found something else more interesting.
Do you think it might be Captain Dan Dare? Do you think he's all right?
If your friend has been taken captive by the Treens, I would not hold out much hope.
Your name, right?
Sondar.
Well, your boot fastener's come undone. Well, it was worth a try. For me? You're very kind. No point in poisoning it, I suppose. You could easily have killed me long before this.
Forward, Earthman!
Well, you've got all the charm of an open grave.
Silence! I am the mighty Mekon, ruler of the Treens! And you and your planet are doomed.
Like I said, charming.